Injuries are obviously watching them.
Oh, come on, it doesn't matter.
I wish I could play football. I'd be so amazing. And Gary's so cute.
Ew!
You like Gary!
Look, look, look!
Come on, Gary!
Oh, I'm going to play football! I'm going to play football! Look! I'm going to play football! Step up! Come here! Let's shut up! That's how we go!
Oh, come on, guys!
Go to the shop! Go to the shop! Go, go, go!
No!
Save!
Look at Tommy's face. No one wants to play with him at all.
It's not even mean. He's got his favourite polo shirt on. The blue, it's going to get all dirty.
Let's go again, let's go again, let's go again.
Don't test me.
In today's lesson, we'll be talking about sex. And sex is an important process in the life of all living beings. Male, female, animal, human. It is even important for special students such as yourself. Do that top of your now.
Yes, sir.
Of course, learning about sex is necessary in order to enact it. Just like playing football, you have to learn the skills before you can score a goal. As most of you may have discovered for yourselves, a male is aroused by either a male or a female body. The masculine genitalia begins to rise until fully erect. At this point, it would then enter into the feminine genitalia, the vagina, so the procedure of sex would then commence. Now, there are many different positions that can be applied to the act of sex. I'd like to direct your attention to the board here. We have the basics. Position one. Position two. Position three. Position four. And position five. A male gains an erection when he has strong emotions. It is important to remember that sex affects emotions in ways that you'd never expect. And you have to be careful when having sex with people who aren't students. And the reason is because it means so much more than, say, dancing or playing tennis. Because people out there can have children from having sex, and you can't.
Sir?
That is all.
Jackie and Kathy over there.
Oh, yeah.
You were kind of playing Ruth are there, and they dare me to kiss you.
To kiss me?
Yeah. You don't have to, you don't want to.
Why did they dare you to do that?
Because you're hella cute. And...
Well, are you going to do with that?
Why the sudden interest?
Because I'm just curious.
Well, if you must know, I do not have any children. It never became an option and never will be.
Never became an option? In this day and age?
But please do not patronise me. This is completely inappropriate, Lucilla.
You call me Lucy, you know.
Are we done here?
Miss Lucy! Miss Lucy!
Actually, the composition's quite good for a child of a young age.
Does age even live to the soul? How can we be sure that they even have feelings or anything else, like...
No! You pardon my interruption, madame, but this work is nothing of the sort that we are trying to achieve at this school.
No, I couldn't disagree more. Look at this piece, for example. You can see that the child that has done it is trying to persuade the viewer that they have something deep and meaningful to show.
They are children. Nothing is meaningful to them.
I in fact know this child, and she's very emotional, but I feel her to have a massive breakthrough with her.
A breakthrough? A breakthrough would revolutionise this whole system. I'm sure that the public at large wouldn't feel comfortable if souls were an issue.
The public's comfort is not relevant. Clearly these pictures show no hint of personal creativity at all. It is a waste of time.
What? I really don't understand why you have to be so harsh, Emile.
Well, if this is all we can say, we can now continue to go and observe the children themselves. Please follow me.
I'm a head teacher at this school. When this place was built, they offered me the job as head teacher here. And I was hesitant about acceptance at first. I didn't know the half of what would be involved. I never knew the actual purpose of this so-called school. I was just overthrown by the fact it was a massive step up from being deputy head teacher in a primary school where I grew up to being head teacher in a well. What I thought was a mainstream school. Don't get me wrong, this school is popular, but not in the way you'd hope. They both pleaded for me to accept this job, because they knew that they didn't have what it takes to run a school like this. Neither of them could do what I do. I may seem unprofessional speaking in this manner, but the purpose of this school is disgusting. Raising what they call children to take them apart and kill. It's appalling. But I think I do well to hold my tongue.
Why you speak about these children in such a way. This concerns their souls.
Souls? They don't have souls. The government states that to be true, and I does not agree.
Now, Emile, how can you say that about children? Look at them. They're absolutely fine. There's nothing wrong with them at all.
Really?
It's mine!
Girls!
And they're all animals!
No, stop! No. How dare you? Now, how bloody dare you? I've worked my entire life for these children. I've invested my money, as my father did. But you think we're wrong, do you? Think we're wrong in our cause to stop people looking on them like they're parasites? To stop working towards giving them rights and a home and a life? Stopping the things that are happening to them in such a cruel way? And what do you call them, Emile? Animals. They're not subhuman or freaks or anything like that. They're children, Emile. Scared, young children. And no, you're right. I can't stop the government doing what they're doing. But you know what I can do? I can give them the respect they deserve. It is a selfless act in this godforsaken world. They choose not what's going on outside. And you call them animals.
I think I better go. I'll be back next week. Can you please inform Mr. Lucy I'll be looking at the gallery? There's a bag of sweets there. You go and share them with the other one. This is a good one. Hey, Kathy. You all right?
Yeah. I made some for you.
Oh, really?
Wow. That's...
I got the stuff from the sales and then sewed it all together.
That's really nice. That must have taken you ages. How long did you take it?
Not long.
You're so creative.
Ruth's not happy with you. She says you bring all your problems on yourself.
You know how she is.
But it's just I've been thinking. You're a lot calmer these days. You're just different.
I know.
Oh, okay.
I remember when it all started. The anger and everything. I was in an art class with Miss Geraldine before Miss Lucy got here. She asked us to draw something and I drew an elephant and everyone started laughing at it.
You didn't mean to.
But yes, you did. Everyone saw it that day. She asked us to draw it and everyone thought I was doing it as a joke. Then she had to find something good with it, Mom. Well, she couldn't.
You're just worried about you, Tommy. Everyone else has never been important for creating.
Yeah, everyone knows. I know you that pretty well for a few years. No one talked to me, Kathy. Everyone left me out of games. Then a few months would go past and nothing would happen. I think it was all over. Then someone like Arthur Hage would bring it all back up again.
But that's the thing. It's all stopped. You try to drink. I've seen you walk in Alexander J. I'm Peter N. And everyone says your name differently now. You're different. You are. But
I'm still not creative. My work hasn't changed. That's it, isn't it?
You just seem happier these days. Things seem to be going much better for you.
You know, it's everything, don't you, Kathy? Yeah, I guess you're right. Everything is going a lot better for me. I'm a lot better.
What happened? You found God or something?
I guess I just grew up.
And?
You're so nosy, Kathy.
I'm not nosy, I just care.
Alright, I suppose there is something, but you can't tell anyone, okay? A few months back, I had this talk with Miss Lucy. And she said something, and it made me all feel much better.
So what did she say?
Well, thing is, it might sound strange. I mean, it did to me at first. What she said was, if I didn't feel like being creative, if I really didn't feel like it, that was perfectly all right. Nothing wrong with it, she said.
That's what she told you?
Yeah, yeah.
That's just ridiculous, Tommy. You play a stupid game and just can't bother.
Kathy. It's true. She said, she's going on about these students that she'd had. Struggled to be creative, but then one day just blossomed. She said maybe I was one of them. She said that if I genuinely tried my hardest, that if I honestly tried as hard as I could, then it didn't matter how creative I am. It was wrong with anyone, students or guardians, to punish me for it.
It's just a funny thing for her to say. Are you sure you got it right?
Of course I got it right. She said it right to my face, Kathy. Just you remember, Tommy, there's at least one person here at Hailsham who thinks you're a very good student, as good as she's ever come across, no matter how creative you are. When she said it, she was shaking.
What do you mean shaking?
Shaking with rage. She was furious. I don't know who or what with, but she was angry, all right.
You're pretty weird, Tommy.
Funny thing is, this talk, when you were saying earlier on about how I seem better, well, it's because of that talk. But listen, you can't whisper a word of this to anyone, okay?
I just don't understand. Everyone knows it's important for creative. Mr. Mills is always inspecting our work. And what about the gallery? Why would we have to do that if we didn't have to
be creative? I don't know, Cass, but have you ever just sat down and thought about all the weird things that go on here at Hailsham?
Just stop making conspiracy.
I'm not. I mean, what about the gallery? All the checks with Dr. Porter? There's something
I can see you two are discussing something of extreme importance.
Tommy was just telling me about all the weird things that go on in Hailsham. I think he's been your dramatic.
I am not. I swear down. I notice things.
Don't be ridiculous. You haven't seen anything.
He's got a point, though.
What?
Oh, don't look at me like that. I mean, you must have noticed when Madame is always scared of us.
Scared of us? How can she be scared of us?
I think I'm more scared of her.
I'm sure she is, because she's always asking about our health and our fitness. But I think if she really cares, she'd want to get up real close and ask us herself.
Well, how can we prove it?
Well, today, I overheard Mr. Emile saying that she was coming for a visit. We'll do it. We'll get a bunch of us. We'll go right up to her and walk around her. I bet you anything she'll jump.
Ruth, I think you're going a little bit too far here.
It's fine. Come on, I'll show you.
Don't think she's going to tell us after you.
Oh, you're such a wuss, Captain. It's not like we did anything wrong.
You just can't get making me so relaxed about it already. We proved she's scared of us. It must mean something.
Oh, no.
Dr. Porter, he was okay.
Yeah, he was fine. Just making sure we're in tip-top shape as usual. Listen, I gotta go. Tommy's waiting for me. See you later.
Oh, good morning, Catherine. Please come in and take a seat. You've nothing to worry about. This is just a routine checkup. Madame will be here for our session, so she'll be on in a minute. Oh, good morning, miss. Yeah, I think we can get started now. First of all, you haven't had any colds recently, have you? Any sore throats, anything like that? No? You've been eating fine, haven't you? Good. Any sort of nausea or feeling dizzy or... No, you feel fine and you're happy? Okay, brilliant. That's fine. Just a quick test here. I want you to just follow the pencil. Is that alright? Yeah, that's fine. Just make sure this is absolutely normal. Okay, it's been a while since we've taken you away. I'm just going to weigh you. If I could just actually stand up, please. If you'd just like to pop on there, we'll have a look. All right, sit down, please. Just one second.
What's wrong? Am I ill? I can't be ill.
There's nothing wrong, Catherine. Just check that in. You are eating plenty, aren't you? And you're getting plenty of exercise. Catherine, you're very underweight. It's nothing to worry about. I'm sure it's just something to do with your diet. I have a diet plan somewhere. I'll wait there. I'll just go and grab one.
Kathy, would you mind maybe explaining to me what that was yesterday? You and your little friends attacking me in the middle of the corridor, touching me, looking... I have never been so frustrated by any pupil in the history of this school, Catherine. One more time, and I will assure you, you will all three be separated. Do you understand me?
Now, I'm sure I've got you in here somewhere, where is it? There's nothing to worry about, dear. You're not in trouble. Don't worry, no one's mad at you. Don't worry. Here you are, then. If you take that and just follow it, you'll be absolutely fine, and you're ready for any no time. Yes, that's everything, Catherine. You can go. Madame, I'm just giving you the flowers, that's all. Thank you very much.
Pick yourself up, child. Stop making a mess of my school. You want to speak with me, Madame?
Emile, I have no idea what you are doing at the school, but it is completely not up to standards yet. These children are rude, insubordinate, impolite, filthy, and just generally not what I would expect at this stage. One more slip up for me and I will make sure that you are fired.
Very soon. across mass at 3 in the morning.
I'm scared.
Look, everything will be better.
Soon, Gwen. Very soon. Very soon. I promise. Promise.
You really promise?
I do. Now, what are you doing here anyway?
I came to see you, Lord.
Mummy?
Mummy?
You think I'm your mummy? I'm not your mummy, Kathy. You don't have a mummy. You don't have a mummy, Kathy. You're a freak. Freak. You're not even human. You're not even human.
You were created in some lab.
You're an experiment. Oh, Kathy, darling, you're the reason I'm getting better. Don't you see how beautiful it is? How beautiful it is. The part of you living inside of me. Your kidneys. Do you remember giving them to me? Look, you're all chopped up.
Decent lives, you have to remember that. sorry, I am. I never wanted to be the one to tell you this. I mean,
you knew. You knew all along, and you never told us.
She couldn't do anything. She was just tied up.
She could do everything. She could have.
Ruth, come on, we can talk about this.
Where is she?
We don't know. No one knows.
The woman who I am. Where is she?
Because you don't need to know. Just don't make this harder than it is.
Never even left Hailsham.
Just for your own safety.
Screw safety. If I'm gonna die, at least let me have this.
Ruth,
I'm so sorry. I am. I never.
Washed up. They never waited long enough. The time.
tiny figure would appear on the horizon. It would get larger and larger until I could see it was Tommy. He'd smile, maybe even wave. Fantasy never got beyond that. Never let it. No tears streamed down my face when I woke up. I wasn't sobbing or out of control. Just wait a while and go back to where I was supposed to be. I loved him so much. Later he told me that Ruth was always different to us. She kept wanting to believe in things. That was Ruth. I guess that's why she completed so early. Part of me kept wishing I could have shared everything with her. She wanted the best for me and Tommy in the end. And we never got it. And that was your fault.
You're the only one left, Kathy. Truly in love, is that what you think? You really think that?
I came for a deferral.
And you really believe that you were truly in love?
I was. So they left now. The only one who had.
Hailsham closed down, child.
The gallery. All our lives are left. I wanted to see the gallery.
The gallery. All those pieces of artwork and poetry that I collected, that was hard work for me. And you think it's so that I could see if you could feel love.
But I can't you. What did you want with us?
I thought if anything, we could give you an educational environment to grow in and to excel in like any other child. We could prove to all the naysayers, look, these children are every bit as creative and intelligent as your children. The tide was with us back then.
You hated us. You wouldn't touch us. We were subhuman to you.
And I'm sorry. I am so sorry about that. I thought like all the other teachers and people in the world that you were abominations. The way that you were made, your very existence, it terrified me. It frightened me to death. But then I saw you for who you really were. You were all just scared children and we ruined your lives. And you are the only one left because the others had to be completed.
Because I'm a carer. Because I care for those that they died. And now it's my turn.
Your life would cause too much of a controversy.
I see.
Are you ready?
Now this is
yes.
Over.
Yes, you can. It's just one more.
Oh.